Hi friends, so in this video we are gonna see nth derivative of some more functions. So let's start with it. So let's consider a function y equal to cos of ax plus b. Now to find out the nth derivative, we will use a technique by using which we will find the nth derivative, and the technique is first find out first derivative, then find out second derivative, then find out third derivative. After that, from first, second and third derivative, guess what could be the nth derivative. So I'm gonna use that procedure. So let's find out the first derivative. So y1 is called as first derivative of function y. So the derivative of cos x is minus of sin x, that is minus of sin of ax plus b into a. Now let's find out second derivative, that is y2. But if I find out the y2 over here, I will get y2 as again cos. Then if I find out the y3 from this y2, I will get a sine from that cos. So it means in each and every derivative, I am getting sine, then cos, then sine, then cos. That is alternative sine and cos. And hence it will become very difficult to guess what could be the yn, because we don't know the value of n. And hence I will use one more method, that is every time to find out the further derivatives, I will first generalize the given term in terms of cos only, because our question is in terms of cos. That here the trigonometric ratio is cos. Hence every time I will convert the answer in terms of cos, and then I will find out the next derivative. So if I want to convert this minus sign term in cos, then we all know that cos of pi by 2 plus theta is minus sine theta. So here in this case the theta is ax plus b, so I'll say it is pi by 2 plus ax plus b. So I'm using the formula cos of pi by 2 plus theta as minus sine theta, and as a is a constant, I will write it down as it is, and this will become my new value of y1. Now let's find out y2 from this new value of y1. So y2 of this cos is again minus sine of pi by 2 plus ax plus b into a square. So if I want to find the next derivative y3, I have to convert this minus sign into a cos term, and then we'll proceed. So to convert this minus sign term into cos term, we will again use the formula cos of pi by 2 plus theta, because cos of pi by 2 plus theta is minus sine theta. So here the theta is pi by 2 plus ax plus b. So I will write it down as cos of pi by 2 plus theta. Theta is pi by 2 plus ax plus b, and this time this will become a square. Next I can rewrite this as cos of 2 times pi by 2 plus ax plus b into a square. So now my friends, I got the value of y1, I got the value of y2, and now it's time to guess the value of yn. So I'll say in yn the answer will be definitely a cos term, and in the angle part, see here, when it was y1 I was getting once pi by 2 plus ax plus b, when it was y2 that time I was getting twice pi by 2 plus ax plus b. Similarly, when I am finding nth derivative, I will get ax plus b plus n times pi by 2. So bracket is ax plus b plus n times pi by 2. And similarly, here in y1 we were having a raised to 1, y2 we were having a raised to 2, and in yn we will get a raised to n. And this is the nth derivative of cos of ax plus b, which we will use to solve many problems. Now let's see nth derivative of some more functions. Now let's say the function is y equal to ax plus b raised to m. So, to find out nth derivative, we will use the same approach. So, let's start with first derivative. So, therefore, the first derivative, that is y1, will be given as m into ax plus b raised to m minus 1 into a. Now, let's find out the second derivative. So, second derivative, we will get it from first derivative, that is y1. So, let's differentiate this y1 to get y2. Now, m and a, as they are constant, I will keep them as it is. So, m and a as it is. Next, let's find the derivative of this. It is m minus 1 into ax plus b raised to m minus 2 into a. So, now a will become a square. Now, let's find out the third derivative from this. So, therefore, y3 will be, see, to find out the third derivative, I am keeping m, a square and m minus 1 as it is because they are constant. And I am just finding the derivative of this term. So, the derivative of ax plus b raised to m minus 2 is m minus 2 into ax plus b raised to m minus 3 into a. So, it means we are getting a square into a as a cube. Next, m minus 1, m minus 2 into ax plus b raised to m minus 3. And guys, now it's time to predict what could be the yn. Now, let's observe the pattern. Now, in y1, I was getting a raised to 1. In y2, I got a square. In y3, I got a cube. So, I can say that in yn, I will get, yes, it is a raised to n. Similarly, let's observe the remaining terms. In y1, I was just getting m. In y2, I got m into m minus 1. In y3, m minus 1, m minus 2. So, guys, if you'll observe the last term of this pattern, of this series, then every time I'm getting the last term as 1 less than that particular derivative. So, when I was finding the third derivative, I got 2 in the last term. When I was finding the second derivative, I got 1 in the last term. So, can I say that when I will find out the nth derivative, I will get last term as n minus 1. So, the pattern will be m into m minus 1, m minus 2 and so on till m minus n minus 1 as a last term. Now, pay attention, I am keeping the bracket for that n minus 1 because the minus sign is outside. Now, let's observe the last term. Now, here in y1 I was getting ax plus b raised to m minus 1. Y2, I was getting ax plus b raised to m minus 2. In y3, ax plus b raised to m minus 3. So, minus 1 in case of y1, minus 2 in case of y2. Similarly, in case of yn, I will get minus n. So, hence the last term is ax plus b raised to m minus n. Now, let's rewrite this term. So, we will get yn as a raised to n into m minus 1 dot 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 m minus n plus 1 into ax plus b raised to m minus n. So, this is the formula to find out the nth derivative of ax plus b raised to m. Now guys, let's observe one more thing, that this formula is applicable when this m is less than the n. So, I'll say, so guys, let's observe one more thing, that this formula is applicable when this m is greater than this n. So, it means if m is greater than n, then this formula is applicable. Now, let's see if m and n are equal, then what happens if m is less than n? So, when m and n both are equal, then that time in this last term, the changes will be like this. So yn will become a raised to n, that term will remain as it is. Here, as m and n are equal, I am saying that m and n are equal. So, this n will become m and m minus m will become 0 and I will get only 1. So, the last term of this series will be 1. Similarly, here the power will become ax plus b, m minus m, that is 0. Now, let's rewrite this a raised to n as it is. Next, m into m minus 1, m minus 2 till 1 is nothing but m factorial and ax plus b raised to 0 is 1. So, it means I am getting yn as a raised to n into m factorial. Now, let's see one more case. The third case is nothing but what will happen if value of m is less than n. Now, let's see guys. So, in this case, this yn will be 0. Now, how? Now, since m is less than n, so, if I will try to find out the first, second, third, fourth, fifth derivative, at one step, I will get the derivative as 0. And once I will get 0 in any of the derivative, all the remaining derivatives or the further derivatives will be 0. And hence, yn will be 0 in that case.